Today we came to visit this new Goodwill in our general area. It's the Goodwill Central Texas Belcones store. It's off Highway 183 in Austin.
Get a devil bear. And a piggy. Okay, let's go. Can you be in charge of my cart? Oopsie. Oh, go look for jeans, but just be in charge of the cart. Jeans are on this side, actually. Gonna try to slow down for you guys. I can't promise anything. I'm trying my best. Kind of in a rush today. Some quilts. $4.99. This looks like a cute one. A little baby quilt. I kinda like it. I think I'm gonna take it.
Sorry, once I got to the back of the store, the music did get loud, so I had to add some voiceovers and some background music. So I thought this slow cooker was pretty cool looking. It was pretty like 70s looking to me. It didn't have the box. If it had the box, I probably would have bought it. They did want like, I think $10 for it, so it was kind of on the pricier side. So I really like the look of this crown pottery teacup and saucer. It was only $1.99 for both the cup and the saucer. I ended up taking it with me, but later on when I was inspecting the item, it did have a hairline crack on the inside, so I had to leave it behind. So my husband spotted these vintage plates, four of them on the shelf. They are vintage in the graphic only, not age-wise. I'm probably gonna end up giving them away as a free gift in my eBay packages. Whoever is a YouTube subscriber and buys from me on eBay will get one of these plates. So were you guys just as intrigued as I am by things in old looking boxes? This was only an Avon anniversary plate. It still would have been pretty for fall decoration, but I didn't end up taking it with me. So these blue bowed duck or geese enamelware bowls caught my attention, but when I picked them up and inspected them further, they were very heavily damaged and had a lot of utensil marks on the inside, so I passed on them. Here's the part where we saw the hairline crack on the inside of the crown pottery teacup, so we put it back on the shelf. These salt and pepper shakers looked pretty retro to me. I don't know if they are or not, but I did end up buying these for resale. vintage clear glass diamond patterned decanter caught my attention. It looks pretty. I considered taking it for my bar cart back at home, but I did see the price and I didn't want to pay $7 for it, so I ended up leaving it behind.
Whoa, look at he has a crack in him. Literally, he has a crack. So, I'll pass on this one. Bye, guys.
So, in my local Goodwill, we're not allowed to shop out of the carts, but this was not my local Goodwill. It was further out in Austin. I saw other people picking out of the cart, so I assumed it was okay to do it also. I spotted this cross stitch piece in here and ended up taking this with me. Here's another Goodwill I've never been to. This is Goodwill Central Texas in Lake Creek, still in Austin off the 183.
Hey guys, we just walked into the motherlode of all Goodwills in this one. This sucker is humongous. Probably the biggest. Get a cart. Biggest Goodwill I think I've seen ever. Hopefully we find some good stuff at this one. It's pretty quiet in here too. There's no loud music blaring. It's cute. Dang, this Goodwill is good. This Goodwill's huge, babe. Absolutely huge. It's humongous, huh? Probably have some decent furniture here, babe.
You sit down.
So you're heading for furniture. But follow me, though. I always try to hit, like, the dish area first. Here's another one of these Gemco food choppers. I think I'll take this chop chop. Chop suey. Here's the cookie press.
There's these a lot.
I know. I see them everywhere. Mm-hmm. Oh, here's one of those juicers. Should we get one of these?
Yeah,
we
look
like
making
squeezed
orange juice.
It's
$3.99. But then again, we can always get
a vegan. That's cute. Made in England. Kinda like it because of the orange. Around the corner, guys. I spotted some of these. This one's cute. Kinda like this one from me. This is a maybe. I might take this. I don't know. That's a maybe. I don't know, guys. This Goodwill is huge, but I don't know if they're getting much quality stuff. Or they might be getting it and putting it online on Goodwill. Strawberries. Kind of ugly, though. To get one single strawberry plate, and it's made in China. Pass. I have this same avocado green platter. I think I'm gonna add this one. It's by Fire King. Here, we'll take this. Oh, in the corner once again. Maybe we will have better luck in vases or figurines. There's a cockatoo vase. Opal house. It's modern Target. These are left over. What is this for, guys? I kind of like this even though I don't know what it's for. So, that guy's kind of cute. Does this glow? Yeah, I do. Can you grab it? This kind of looks like Vaseline glass. You think it'll glow? I think it's in my tote bag. These are kind of cute. They're heavy. Okay, these little birdie thingies.
Got it.
Cute. Okay, shine it in there.
What do you think?
No? Yeah, look. Towards the rim, because the bottom's dirty, has to be washed. I can't tell. Does that glow, guys? Let me see. No, I don't think it does. This is cute, too. $4.99. What? What else can we find? Okay, we got. We'll probably do figurines next. And then we're out of here. Let's
go. So, this was the biggest Goodwill I've ever visited here in Texas and actually back in California as well. There wasn't a lot on the shelves. I think it's probably due to COVID. Maybe a lot of people aren't donating or don't want to get out to donate their items. So, even though the shelves look full, there was not a lot of stuff for resale. Hey guys, it's me, Laura Melendez from Vintage Thrifted Treasures. Got my Chick-fil-A iced coffee here with me. Have one of those like every single day. So today I'm going to share with you what I bought from those two humongous Goodwills that I visited on the Thrift With Me part of this video. I actually hit 4 Goodwills that day. Everything was pretty darn scarce. I don't know why, but I didn't pick too much up. Let's start off with these cool salt and pepper shakers. These are these got my attention because I liked the blue and white, or the blue and navy. Blue and navy? Did that make sense? No, white and navy. Sorry, I'm learning my colors. Anyways, these are Viana de Castello salt and pepper shakers. They're made in Portugal. They are these cool looking like rectangular salt and pepper shakers. They are vintage. These will be up for sale in my eBay store. They're in good condition. No cracks or chips or anything. I paid, the tags say $3.99 each, but this day yellow was half off. So I ended up paying $2 a piece for both of them. So yeah, these will be up for sale. I also picked up these salt and pepper shakers, and I got these because they looked retro to me. They looked vintage, but I've done research for the past 2 days and I could find absolutely nothing similar to these salt and pepper shakers. They don't have a maker's mark. They got a patent number, US, and a bunch of numbers. I've tried looking them up and no information is coming up on these, so I'm not too sure how much they sell for or who the maker is. I paid $1.99 for both of them, so 99 cents a piece. They've got the pink and these black and yellow stoppers. They've got the chrome tops. This one needs to be cleaned off a little bit, but yeah, I just thought they looked pretty cool. Like they, I don't know, be in a cool like diner somewhere. These will be up for sale. I'm not gonna keep these. So If any of you guys know what these are, leave a comment in the video down below. Let me know, because I'm very interested to see if anybody knows any information on them. The video you guys saw me pick up this Gemco chopper. It was, let me see, how much did I pay for this? Oh, I paid $4 for it. So $4. And I picked up another one of these recently. I don't know if it was in another video, it could have been, but it was the like cream colored top. I'm probably gonna keep this one and sell the cream colored one, just because I like this color yellow and it would look nice in my kitchen with all of the vintage strawberry stuff that I've been collecting. It'll kind of go with it. So yeah, I picked up this. It was pretty nice. Just little nut chopper or onion chopper or whatever. I grabbed these two Aladdin thermos jars, or these insulated jars, storage jars. I thought they looked cool, and they would look cool for like a fall themed display. And let's see, they're a little bit dirty. I'll have to clean them off. I paid $2 a piece for these. I'm not gonna hang on to these. They will be up for sale. They don't sell for much, but they will be up for sale in my eBay store. I will keep them in my display for now, because I am transitioning all of my summer items to fall decor, and so these will be up for sale, but they will be safely in my display for now until someone buys them. I picked up this piece here. I am gonna keep this mug. I do collect vintage, like St. Patrick's Day items, just because I do a display on my living room dresser every year, and I thought this would look cool with some, I don't know, candy or snacks or a fake plant or something. It is put out by Hall, made in the USA, and it's just this vintage 1968 mug here. March from MacArthur. I don't know who MacArthur is, but I just thought it looks cool. So he will be going into my collection of St. Patrick's Day decorations. Another piece I'm keeping, well, I'm not keeping it. My daughter picked up this mug on the way out of that second Goodwill that you saw, the one that was just humongous. She saw this mug and she thought it was cool, so she's gonna keep this for herself. We paid 99 cents for it, and the brand there says Fish's Eddie. Anyways, so you could kind of take a marker and write a little note on it or whatever, but just this heavy style mug that she's gonna keep for her. I picked this guy up because I thought he looked like real kitschy looking with his big old eyes, and it's this speckled glazed look. I don't know what this is used for, guys. If you look at it from side view, it looks like it would hold napkins, but this is too curved, so napkins would just slip right out of this. So I don't think it was meant for that, but I don't know what it would. I don't know what would go in here. So if you guys know, again, this piece, let me know in the comments what you think this was intended for. He is going to be for sale. I paid $4 for it. Just thought it was real cute with this speckled, it has like a, it's like cream with a green speckled glaze, and then the turtle has a little dragonfly on him. Super cute. Looks kind of kitschy. Maybe it would have gone in a bathroom. I don't know. Maybe to hold a hand towel. Possibly. I don't know. My husband found these vintage plates on the shelf, vintage only in the graphic, not in age. This is a newer plate, but I picked them up because I thought, you know, this would be cool if you like displayed it on a little, like, one of those little wooden stands, like I have here, like so. Let me see, I have a wooden stand here. You could just put it in a display like that, or maybe on your desk. I'm gonna keep one for myself. I did end up picking up a set of four, so I got three more here. And these three I'm gonna give away. If you are a subscriber to my channel and you purchase from me on eBay and let me know before checking out and send me a message, you will get one of these for free with your purchase. And I've only got three left, so the first three will get one of these cool little vintage plates. So just thought that was cool. Also picked up this piece of like a chrome, what are these called on the ships, like the helm, I guess the helm. And now looking at it, actually it looks like it was broken off of something, because yeah, look, those two pieces there look like they were broken or something. Every other thing is real smooth. So maybe this went on something and it just came off. But I just thought it was cool. I know people, they like to decorate their homes in like that nautical style. So I just thought this would be a cool piece to like, maybe just, I don't know, stick in a planter or decorate with it somehow. I don't know. Maybe you can even use one of these. Maybe something like that. I don't know. You guys could be creative. This will be for sale. I think I paid, this is $2.99 on it. Wow, I should have looked at that a little bit better. Oh yeah, this green plate. This is a Fire King dish. It's a large round platter, and I paid $4 for this one. This one, huh, odd. This one does not have the mark on it, so now I'm second guessing myself. Now I'm gonna have to compare it to the one I do have, because it looks exactly like it. The last two things I got, or three things rather, I picked up these shirts for my older sons. I thought maybe they would think they were cool, because I know Hawaiian is always kind of in. It's these 100% silk Hawaiian, or not Hawaiian Republic, Island Republic shirts. I paid $7 for this one. It is a size large. These are going to be for sale because my boys did not think they were cool, or it's not their style, I guess. Just this cool Hawaiian print. And I'm pretty sure the buttons are made out of like coconut shell or something like that. I think somebody told me that once. No rips or stains or anything, so this one will be up for sale. The other one I got is the same brand and same size. It is this color here. And it is Island Republic. I also paid $7 for this one. Size large. Just this cool Hawaiian print. Now, my oldest son thought this one was cool, but he just said he didn't think he would ever wear it. So, these will be up for sale. And then the last thing I picked up, you guys saw it in the video, was this little blanket. I bought this for my daughter. She's gonna be 2 years old soon. She's my youngest. But she loves snuggling like on the couch when we're watching a movie, or having a little Bible study before bedtime. She likes to snuggle with a blanket. So I just thought this was a sweet little, I don't know, some parts looked hand-stitched to me. So I don't know if it was a hand-stitched quilt or maybe both, because these right here, if you notice, they don't look all alike, like the stitching here. So I think some parts were hand-stitched, and then other parts, like if you notice here, this looks more like a sewing machine did it. Looks too uniform. So, yeah. So I just thought this would be cute for her. It had these cool little retro print on here. I'll turn it around for you guys. That the fabric looked vintage on some of these little girl silhouettes. The blanket was $4.99. We will be keeping this. I'm gonna wash this, and this is gonna be for my daughter. And that was it, guys. Two huge Goodwills, four for the day, and this was all I picked up. So pickings were pretty slim. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite piece was of this haul. If you guys have any information on that guy there or those two salt and peppers there, let me know in the comments below what you think. And I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to comment, like the video, share it if you wish. Hit that notification bell to get updates of when I upload the next video. And I will see you guys on my next Thrift With Me and haul. Bye, guys. Wait, don't go anywhere, guys. I totally forgot about this last piece.
This piece of cross stitch.
I thought it would look pretty for Christmas. This was in the bins towards the back. We're not allowed, or at my local Goodwill, we're not allowed to shop off the bins until they actually take it from the bins and put it onto the shelf. But I saw other people doing it, like I said in the video, and so I thought it was fine. There was no workers back there working the cart, so yeah, I spotted this. I saw on the tag down here it was $5.99, and it said for the set. So I don't know if someone just didn't change their price gun. I know there's like an option on their little pricing guns for like a set or each. But I just thought it looks cute. I'm gonna put this up. I don't like the frame. I'll probably end up painting the frame a different color, maybe black or something. Or maybe even white, a white frame. And I'm gonna put it up in my house for Christmas. So, just thought that was a nice little snowscape there.